in the middle of what they call Plan Bogert. It's they're going to build houses here, and it's not very far from a digging site. Yes, there was 2 years ago an archaeology research down here before they started building the first houses over there, and they did find some interesting findings. About 21 Roman graves, for example, and also they did found some Iron Age findings, and also I believe some prehistoric findings from even there before. So I went to this field, so it's now empty. They're going to start build houses in about half a year from now, and I've done my first 2 hours with a metal detector here. And well, we found a very interesting piece of iron. I've cleaned it now for over 20 days. It has been in acid to remove all the rust, and it's brushed clean. And I'm going to show it later, and then I'm going to determine it, what it is exactly.
Before talking about what we found, first we're going to talk shortly about the history of Udenhout while doing some aerial reconnaissance. We used our drone to do the aerial filming and photography. Due to the weather, we could not climb higher than 45 meters, otherwise our drone would drift off. So We climbed to 60-65 meters, but we saw the drone drifting off and we had to drop till the altitude of 45 meters to stay in position. In the 11th and 12th century, the Grand Ducie of Brabant was formed. Udenhout is in the north part of the Ducie, south of the city of 's-Hertogenbosch and north of the city of Tilburg. Other important cities in the Ducie were Antwerpen, Leuven and Brussels. In our modern times, the Ducie is torn apart and divided by Belgium and the Netherlands. Udenhout is in the Dutch part of Brabant. In an old document from 1232, the name Udenhout is mentioned for the first time. The meaning of the name has something to do with being an unused rural forest. So officially, Udenhout is from 1232, but we know it's older. Remember the Roman findings. 21 Roman graves is not nothing. This, combined with the fact that they did not dig up the whole place, means there could be much more. Between the fall of the Roman Empire in 476 and the rise of the Frankish Empire, there was a major depopulation in Brabant. So we can imagine this happened also in Udenhout. In later videos we'll show some of the oldest buildings, but for now that's it about Udenhout. So, well, here we are for the final part of our video. I'm sitting here with my son Maxime, who is with us flying with the drone. He was also with me 3 weeks ago to do the metal detecting. So we went to the area we just filmed from the air, which you just saw. They're going to build houses there in about half a year, so we still have time to do some more searches, but we want to share our first finding. So we did find a piece of iron. I'll show you right here how it looked just after cleaning. At first I didn't think I had found something, but just to be sure I put it in acid for 10 days, 15 days. And then after that I put it in a tumbler. That's a machine which with stones and water and soap, and it turns around for an hour or two, three. And then came it out just looking like this. this, what you see here. So I started thinking, could that be the ending of a knife or something like that? Maybe. So I did some posts on some archaeological sites, and also I have my own book to determine. And when you look at my picture, especially at the last part of it, it's very much like this, which is described in this determination book of Roman findings. Yeah, Celtic and Roman findings, it is. It's a standard work for determination. And, well, I just found there the picture of a Roman knife blade. It's almost identical. This combined to the fact that on some archaeological groups also people said, well, yeah, this might be a Roman knife. It's iron, that's for sure. It's magnetic. It's old. And it's, you can see it's handmade. It's, at least that's what it looked like. It's not made in a machine or something like that. So, yeah, of course, in later periods also could have made knives. But it looks a lot like the Roman knife. So for now, we just say it's a part of a Roman knife. So we have our first Roman finding. Thank you for your attention. And hopefully I see you in the next video. Don't forget to... it's over there. It's over on the other side. The bell. Yes. Because we want you back. And you can also, of course, go to our Patreon site and become a Patreon. The link will be below the video. Thank you.